Okay, let us continue with then this activation record right here. J is not zero. I have 4 minus the weight of 1. 4 minus 2 gives me positive 2, so this test fails. So I'll go down here and I'll make 2 recursive calls. First recursive call is I don't use 1. That means all the weight right here is still available. The second recursive call is I do use 1. That means the only weight that's left is my 4 minus 2. So that gives me 2 right there. Okay, let us go ahead and calculate our return values for these things. So 0 comma 4 will return 0. 0 comma 2 returns 0. So I have 0 for this and 0 for this when j equals 1. So it's the max between 0 and w1 plus 0. w1 is 2. So obviously the max will be 2 right there. That means that if I have a set containing right here, this means if I have a, I can consider the items containing only item 1 and I have a maximum allowed weight of 4 to use, then the best I can do is to end up with a total weight of 2. And that total weight of 2 will happen if I choose item 1. Okay, now I've got these two things computed, so I can actually go up here where j equals 2 now. So here I have the result here is 2 for this one, and I have the result of 2 for this one right here. So I need to add w sub 2 to this. So 2 plus 2, 2 plus 2 equals 4. That would be the maximum, so that'll be my return value, 4. This means that if I have the items 1 and 2 and a total maximum allowed weight of 4, the best I can do is to pick items that will total up to 4, and I can see right here if I pick 1 and 2, those will total up to 4, and that's where I get that weight from. Okay, let us proceed. I'm over here with 2 and 3. J's not 0. 3 minus the weight of 2, so 3 minus 2 equals 1, so this test fails. 1 is not less than 0, so this test fails, so I'll be making 2 recursive calls here. Myself's a little room here. So the first recursive call is, I don't actually use 2, so I'm going to just look at the set 1, and then I don't need to decrease that weight since I'm not using 2. The second recursive call right here is, I do use the 2, so the 2, so now I'm looking at the set 1 and I have to modify my weight because I'm using the 2. That gives me 3 minus w sub 2, that is 3 minus 2 gives me a 1 right there. Okay, so now I continue right here. J is not equal to 0, so this doesn't happen. I have got 3 minus w sub 1. That is 3 minus 2 gives me a 1. That is not less than 0. So I'll be making 2 recursive calls right here. Okay, the first recursive call is 1 minus 1 gives me 0. And the amount of weight I have to work with is 3. And then the second recursive call is 1 minus 1 is 0. So I'll be working on the empty set. And the amount of weight I have to work with is 3 minus w sub 1, that is 3 minus 1, 3 minus 2, w sub 1 is 2, that gives me a 1. Okay, let's continue with right here. So I have 1 and 1 at this point. Okay, j equals 0, no. I have 1 minus w sub 1, that is 1 minus 2, that gives me a minus 1. This test is now true. So I make a single recursive call right here where I'm looking at the empty set. And I don't take away anything from my weight, so I have 1 right there. Okay, I can now start to calculate all the rest of my return values, so let me go ahead and do that. Here I have j equals 0, so I'll return a 0. J equals 0, so I return 0. J equals 0, so I return 0. So now at this point, I have the result of my 2 recursive calls. Here is 0, and here is 0, and I need to add w sub 1 to this 0 right here. W sub 1 is 2, so 2 plus 0 gives me 2. Okay, here I have the result is this recursive call right here. Result of that recursive call, the result of this call right here was 0, and that's what I have to return. So that gives me a 0 right there. Okay, now here I have J is 2, and I have now the result of my two recursive calls right here, 2 and 0. So this thing right here gives me 2. This one right here will give me W sub 2, which is 2, plus 0. So 2 plus 0 versus 2. So that'll be a 2. Okay, now here I have the result of this recursive call is 4. The result of this recursive call right here is 2. So now I have to compare, get the max between 4 and W sub 3, which is 3, plus 2. That gives me 5. So 4 versus 5 gives me 5. So that is the result that I have. And I have 5 basically by choosing 3, and then either by choosing 2 or, either by choosing 2 going this route or not choosing 2 and then choosing 1 instead. So that's the result of doing the recursive implementation. I'm getting the brute force, all my possibilities. This is, let me label that quickly. No 3, yes 3. No 2, yes 2. No 1, yes 1. Okay, so I can go on. So this thing right here corresponds to the empty set. This one right here corresponds to the set only containing item 1. Put that in subset so you're sure of it. So this one contains only item 2. This contains item 1 and 2. This one right here contains, item 3, but no 2 and no 1, so only item 3. This one right here contains 3, no 2 but a 1, so this is 1 and 3. This one right here contains 3 and 2 but no 1, so this is 1 and 2. So there we have, and then this one that I didn't, that I, you know, got chopped off, that's the complete set. Didn't even bother because it would have been too much weight. Okay, so that takes care of the recursive implementation and a trace through. Next step is to look at the dynamic programming implementation where I store intermediate results and I don't have to calculate values over and over again.